Good morning. Hey, can you hear me? Think back. Search your memory for an image of yourself.
Thank you. Thank you. right.
I'm getting bored.
Come and fight me.
I think we have to give up.
It was my fault. That's good.
Do you have enough to drink?
And so we part ways.
Not bad at all.
This is just the beginning.
Keep up the good work.
I apologize.
That way.
I'm sorry. I pray for luck in battle.
And here we part ways.
Let's do it.
That's what you look like. Now, we can finally meet. Are you clear-headed? You will now be reborn as an immortal creature. A Revenant. There are things you will need to know in your new life, so listen well. Each Revenant has a different power coursing through their veins, called a blood code. The best way to learn about it is to try it for yourself. Gift. The fighter blood code grants ever-increasing endurance. It seems you also have a gift that temporarily enhances your attack power. Try it out. Very well. Give it a try. Special blood to activate gifts. This blood comes from Revenants who have forgotten themselves and turned into monsters. The Lost. You can drain Ichor from the Lost by striking them with your weapon. Remember that. Those are the basics of a fighter's gifts. Use and learn each of them well. Thank you. Ordinarily, a Revenant has only one blood code, but you are different. The blood code you once held was broken and has vanished. That has left you with infinite possibilities. You have the unique talent to change your blood code. Come, look deep within yourself. That blood code is known as Ranger. Oh dear, that weapon seems to be too heavy for you. Ray, try switching to a bayonet. Yes, that's much better, isn't it? Oh, firing your bayonet requires Ikor as well. That and gifts means Ikor always seems scanned. That is where the blood veil you have equipped comes in. Using your blood veil will let you quickly drain Ikor from the lost. In addition, this can increase the amount of Ikor you can hold. If you have a chance to drain Ikor from a foe, use it. Up the Ranger blood code and draining. Let us try one more blood code. Now, turn your gaze inward. That is what is called the Caster blood code. Casters possess powers like magic from a fairy tale. With it, you can use gifts to fire projectiles of blood. Bloodshot favors range over power. Let's see. Try learning another gift. You can learn gifts by touching missiles. Try it yourself. That wasn't hard, was it? Now since you've learned it, why not try it out? It's a powerful gift that punishes foes. However, its cost in Ikor is high, so be careful that you use it at the right time. In addition, its power will change according to the blood veil you equip. Blood veils have different affinities for gifts. It can be complicated, but keep it in mind. But you picked it up, right? The disappearance of your blood code has left you with unique, limitless capabilities. Not only can you change blood codes, but you can acquire new ones as well. The strength of others can become your own, a talent that you alone possess. Since you are the only one who can do this, Your blood is the only teacher you have. Now, awaken and save the world. Welcome back. Hello. How are you feeling? Don't worry, it's okay. I don't remember either. Over there. It's dry, isn't it? We can go slowly. I am here with you. Just a bit farther. We're all right. Spring will slake our thirst. It seems everyone everywhere is thirsty. There is a spring that will cure that thirst, one that weeps tears of blood. That's what they said, anyway. This way. So, it is you. Here. This is for you.
A new spring and a fresh source of labor. Ha ha! We really hit the jackpot.
Get up. It's time for a bit of fun.
On your feet! We're about to go hunt for Bloodbeat. Hurry up and get ready.
Then, whoa, keep it down. Your friend just fell asleep.
Number 3 and 4. Check your gear and come up.
Are you going to kill me too? Anything for a kick, right? Just don't crush my heart.
There's no way we're gonna find...
Looks like the folks upstairs...
The view never improves, does it? We came back home after the war against the Queen and found this mist. Getting close to it causes enough pain to drive you mad, so no one has ever crossed it. There's nowhere to go home to, even outside of this prison.
So, what do you want to know? According to the folks up there, it's a place to keep laborers who gather blood beads. More concisely, it's a slave pen. A human that died but got kicked awake again. That's what you are. A revenant. As long as your heart is intact, you'll keep coming back. But you have to drink blood and you'll become one of the lost. It's ironic. Creatures made to fight the horrors of the Great Collapse now have to fight their own fallen kin. Each time we die, we lose some part of our memory, be it big or small. It's usually nothing important, and you don't even notice you've forgotten. Well, your case is a little rare, I guess. The lost are revenants who have succumbed to bloodthirst and turned into real-life monsters. If our heart is destroyed, we turn to ash. But the lost don't care if they're left with no heart. Still, it takes them a while to come back, which makes them like us revenants. The air in this place has something in it that speeds up the bloodthirst. We call it miasma. The mask helps filter it out. Mistle purifies the air nearby, but it's been drying up lately. Just like the blood springs. Be careful where you take off your mask, unless you want to join the lost. If we revenants don't drink human blood, we join the lost. But humans are scarce after the Great Collapse and all. Folks like us don't get blood, but there's something we can use in its place. Blood beads. I don't know why such a lucky thing came along, but they started appearing after the Queen frenzied and was taken down. There are some who believe that there are tears, but it doesn't matter much to us where they come from. Mistle is a sort of plant that purifies miasma and renders it safe. It's one of the successes of Project Queen. Even if it withers, it can be brought back with medicine made from the Queen's blood. But there's no hope of that now. If activated mistle turned up somewhere, it'd be a big help in exploration. Not everyone wakes up right away. Some are still asleep. We lose our memories and need human blood to survive. Revenants are imperfect, both as weapons and as creatures. But we were needed to fight against the horrors. The Queen was our hope for solving such problems, but... well, bringing back the dead is already stepping outside the realm of humanity. In the end, she went into a frenzy, and there was a great war involving all revenants. That pretty much covers what I can teach you.
Are you going to kill me too? Anything for a kick, right? Just don't crush my heart. Stop already. My body may still be alive, but my soul died long ago. No one could stay sane after dying again and again and again and again. Don't take my memories. My family. I have nothing left.
There's no way we're gonna find blood beads. The missile's all dried up and the miasma keeps getting thicker. Telling us to look for blood beads here is just crazy.
Wandering, they say, the folks up there. They might live in safety. But because of their levy, we have to risk our necks to collect blood beads. Just you wait. One day, I'm gonna make thralls out of the whole lot.
What the hell are you staring at?